Now we're going to take a look on our ad hoc payroll items. So to go there, you go to payroll, ad hoc payroll items. So ad hoc payroll items is used for additional items that you want to add on that is not consistent every month. For example, your employees might be receiving different amount of commissions every month or allowances. So anything that is not consistent, maybe this month they'll be receiving 200, the next month they'll get maybe less than that or more than that, you would be able to use this. So for those who are using or who are receiving fixed allowances, as usual, you'll be able to add in under employee maintenance in their profile and under addition and deduction. Here, you would be able to set a fixed amount, a fixed allowance that will be automatically applied. So back to our ad hoc payroll items. So what you can do here is you can select different types of add-ons that you want to provide to your employees. If you have multiple employees, you can select multiple at once. And if for any chance that you have multiple employees receiving different allowances and all that, you would be able to use our import template. So we can provide you a template that you can fill it up, fill with the respective information and resubmit back into the system. Right, so for example, today I want to provide an additional allowance to my employee. So select the employee, choose allowance, click on new row. In the details, like when will they be receiving this allowance, during the month end process or the first half. Choose the type of allowances, key in the figure, put a description, and if it's any exempted amount, you can choose the rules and also put the contribution details. Alright, so for employees who are receiving piece rate, you will be able to edit or key in the figures via this section here. And for CP38, this is for you to key in the amount of the payment done for CP38 and also use as reference in the future. And normally for payment of arrears, this is normally used to key in the preceding year's income, and this amount will be shown in your EA form, part B number 2. So basically this covers everything that you would need to put in additionally to something that is fixed in their payroll process.